Right, thank you for joining us again today. Now, today's going to be a little bit of an experiment, a bit like this whole webinar itself, trying to do it the GoToWebinar and YouTube. So we just released a glitter brush pack as part of four packs that we're giving away to all of our customers, new and existing. And what I was trying to do was find a way where we could use a new feature and one of the brushes pack and just try and experiment and see if something works out. And in this experimentation, I actually found something which was an effect I was trying to do, which I kind of achieved. So I'm not going to say this is an absolutely perfect effect, but I think it's quite cool if you spend a bit more time on it and perfect it and finesse it. It could be really cool. So first thing I'm going to do, and this is just a little tip and this is just a preference, I'm going to come up to view and I'm going to go to hide artboards because I like a nice white background. I don't like that grey. And all I've done is created a new document and I've put this black background in. So I'm just going to come over to the layers and lock that. Next thing I'm going to do is create a new layer. This is where I'm going to be doing my work. So if I send anything to the back, it's only going to go to the back in this layer. It's not going to go to the back here. So what we're going to do is start off with ink flow. I'm just going to pick a brush. It doesn't really matter how thick it is, because what we're going to do is use ink flow to draw the first shape, but we're actually going to override the ink flow settings when we apply the glitter brush. So the first thing we do is let's get a nice bright, let's go for pink just so we can see what we're doing. In fact, I'll probably have to set that pink. So I've got my brush here, and what I'm going to try and do is just do some big curls. Now I'm using a mouse, I should be using my Wacom tablet, but I haven't got it plugged in. So let's just see if I can start to do something with this. So I'm going to pull that down, going to come up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, and then come out over here. So it doesn't need to be too perfect because we're going to apply the glitter brush, but I just wanted to get this kind of effect to show you what I'm doing. You can obviously finesse it if you've got a Wacom tablet. So now that I've done that, what I'm going to do is apply the glitter brush pack, or one of the brushes. If you haven't already downloaded it, I suggest you go into Astute Manager and download it. In fact, let's just quickly go up here and have a look. And we've got over here in special offers, you can see we've got the packs here, and you can go and download the glitter brush pack there. So that's for all of our customers. Let's just close that off. Now I've already got the pack downloaded. So what I've done is actually, if you go into your brushes, so if you get the brush panel open, pull that out, come over here, go to open brush library, other library. I've gone to where my glitter brushes are saved and opened it up. And now I've got this pack here. So what I can do is just, if I just come over here and say select all unused, let's just get rid of the ones we don't want. And then we'll come over here to our brush pack. We'll select the first one. Just let that wait for a little bit. I've been doing a lot on my Illustrator today, so I have got a little bit of a lag in here. But we're going to select the last one. And then I'm just going to do add to brushes. And what that's going to do is add those brushes to my brush panel. So I can actually close this one if I want, but let's just pull this over here for now. So what I'm going to do is select, let's go for this thick, colourful one here and see what that does. It's just going to think about it. And there you go, that's going to apply that kind of nice sort of confetti type. Let's just do one of the others quickly. Let's just go to gold, see if we can see a little bit more of the flakes in there because that's quite condensed. Let's try that one as well. I just want something nice and thick. So there we go, that'll be perfect. So we've got our glitter there. We could obviously finesse this a little bit. If I open vector first aid and say check selection, it's actually no points could be removed, so we can leave that. And what I'm going to do now is just leave that alone, and I'm going to create some text. So let's come over to our text tool over here. And I'm just going to click on there. I'm just going to change that to a contrast color. So I'm just going to do green at the moment. I've got a font here called Market OT. And let's just increase the size of the text. Bring that up there. In fact, let's make that bright pink just so that it stands out completely different. And what I'm going to do is just change the word. And we're just going to have the word sparkle, just like that. And then I'm just going to increase the size of it. And let's pull that down there, because I want it to sort of sit over the top of the glitter so you can see what we're going to be doing here. And if I just pull that down there, that should be okay. So we've got our glitter brush pack applied to the paths at the back, and I've got my text here. Now, to do what we're going to do, I do need to convert the text into outline. So to do that, I'm going to come up to type, and I'm going to go to create outlines, like so. So now we've got no more live text. The next thing I'm going to do is actually switch the fill and the stroke, and I'm going to fatten that up a little bit as well. So I'm just going to eyeball it. It doesn't really matter what it is. It just needs to be kind of thick enough that you can see what we're going to do. So we'll leave it about there. That'll do for now. In fact, it's still going while it's thinking about it, because there's a little bit of a lag on my machine. So I'm going to go back to 28 and just see what that looks like. Okay, that looks about fine. So now we've got our glitter applied, we've got our text. What we're going to do is use one of the new features that we just added. Now, to do this, I'm going to take my text, and this is going to be my top path, and we've got our path at the back behind. I'm going to select both. I've got my black layer at the back lock, so it's not going to select that. And I'm going to come up to Object, I'm going to come down to Path, and I'm going to go to Path Intersections. Now, this is something that we've just added, and it's better than using the Pathfinder panel. So the Pathfinder doesn't really do what we want it to do here. It kind of does it for single shapes, but when you've got something kind of a little bit more busier like this, it's not going to work. So we've got our path intersections, and what I'm going to do is I want to use the word sparkle, the path from the word sparkle, to cookie cut my lines behind, because I want to start playing with those. So rather than add points to the paths, I'm actually going to ask it to cut. So it's actually going to like punch through and cut those lines up. Now, if I just get the layer panel over, in fact, we'll look at the layer panel when I've clicked OK. So I'm going to click OK, but watch the layer panel once I've clicked OK. What it's done is it's chopped all those lines up into individual paths. So it's going to create a whole bunch of paths in my layer panel. So once that's okayed, it's just going and working its way through now. We'll have a look at what it's done. There we go. We've got it there. So let's open our layers panel. And if we open this up now, you can see all these paths we've got, because we've chopped this glitter one up into smaller pieces. So let's just close that up there. So now we've got sparkle and our paths. Now, the idea of this was I wanted the glitter to kind of pass through the word. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to send the word sparkle to the back. So I'm going to go object, arrange, center back. And what that's done is that's put it behind the glitter. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start to take parts of this glitter. And if you look here, if I just click away from that, if I click on this piece of glitter here, you can see, in fact, let's just zoom in there. Let's just zoom out quickly. Gone in way too heavy there. But look at those lovely vector little sparkles there. Okay, so we've got this path here. What I'm going to do is say object, arrange, center back. And what that's done is it's gone behind some of the text. So let's just zoom out again, just so it's a little bit bigger, and then we'll drag that across. So let's pick another one. Let's pick this one here. And again, this is just a single section, object, arrange, center back. And you can see now what we're trying to do is I'm starting to get this blend of where the glitter's kind of passing through the letters. So let's just go back one more. And now what I'm going to do is I'm not going to do loads of them, because it'll just be it'll take forever and you'll be watching me do this. But you'll get the gist of it. So arrange, center back. We'll come over here, object, arrange, center back. And this is just purely random. This is just going to be experimentation, because we're not really going to know what anything's really going to look like. Let's go for this piece here, object, arrange, center back. There we go. And let's just pull that across. Let's just pick a few more pieces here, object, arrange, center back. Same there. And let's pick this nice big one here. Let's just pull that over. Let's do a couple more with that nice big one there. And we'll do this last one here. In fact, no, I think I'm going to pick one of these down here as well. So what we've done is we've taken that kind of glitter effect, and if we just zoom out now, we can see that, with, like I said, with a little bit more finesse, you could work this a little bit better. But now we've actually got the sparkly lines actually passing through the text. And like I said, you know, if you spend a bit more time in this, you could actually work out how the letters would be blending and how the glitter would actually go through the gaps. But I think for quite a nice effect to have something where it's all nice and mixed up, this is a really good way of using the cookie cutter and the glitter brush to create that kind of 3D effect where you've got the glitter passing through the letters. And it doesn't have to be letters, it could be shapes, it could be anything. But I was just sitting around playing with this, and I thought this would be quite a good test to see how that cookie cutter feature works over Pathfinder. And it really is so much more flexible than the Pathfinder panel as well. So have a try of that. I think you're going to enjoy it. I think you're going to enjoy playing with it once you work out how you can use it. That's my first demonstration. I'm going to quickly now show you a new feature we've added in Phantasm that I really love, and it was something that I asked for. So we're going to jump over to that next. Okay, so this one is Phantasm, and this was a feature that I specifically asked for because we've got it in Stipulism, and that's the use of symbol variants. So that's where you usually would use a symbol. So as you know, if you've got Phantasm or Stipulism, you can create your own symbol, or you can use any kind of custom shape, even something you've downloaded from Adobe Stock, like I've got here for this Christmas doodles. I just simply downloaded it and selected some items for it, so we'll show you that in a second. But in Phantasm, you could create a halftone and use a single symbol. But in Stipulism, you could use a symbol and variants of that symbol, and they could have been anything. And I just thought it'd be quite cool to have that in Phantasm as well, because while Stipulism gives you that kind of organic stippled look, I quite like the uniformity of it in Phantasm. So what we're going to do with this one is going to create something completely from scratch. So I've downloaded this from Adobe Stock, and what I've done is I've selected some particular icons that I wanted for a Christmas pattern. So what I'm going to do now is get my symbols panel open, and I'm just going to take the first symbol, and I'm going to click and drag it into symbols, and I'm going to call it Snow 1. Just change that to graphic. I'm not going to touch anything else, and I'm going to click OK. So that's given us our snow symbol. So this is our base symbol. Now what we're going to do is we're going to select the rest of the symbols. We're going to come up to Object, and you're going to see here you've got something called Create Symbol Variants. So if we click on that, what it's going to say is, what's your base symbol? So we're going to go for Snow 1. And I can delete the selected art after I've created the symbol, which I will do because I don't want it on the page. I might show you something at the end with this. In fact, no, I'm not going to delete it. I'm going to click OK so that it's created the variants. And then I'm just actually going to take them off the page for now, just because if I've got time, I might show you something. But if not, we've got a video on YouTube that shows you it, and that's the space fill feature. So let's just drag this up here. So now that I've got my base symbol and I've got my variants, and you can see here it says Snow 1 VAR 001, 002, 003. That's because these are the variants. So now I'm going to come over to my type tool, and I'm just going to click there, and let's pick a nice big fat old font so we can see what we're doing. Let's go for this one here. It's a good old favorite for the webinars because it's nice and thick. And let's do holidays because that's what we've got coming up, and we'll make that nice and big so we can see what we're doing. There we go. Just move these over here as well. There we go. And I'm going to make that a nice red color. So there we go, holidays. So what I'm going to do now is use Phantasm to create a halftone on this. So I'm just going to pull my Phantasm panel down. We're done with the glitter brush pack, so we can get rid of that and close that off. Let's just pull that out of the way there so we can see what we're doing. Okay, so let's click on Phantasm Halftone, and that's going to bring up our halftone panel, and that's going to give us the default setting. So we've got these black dots, it's monochrome. I'm going to go for sampled color. I'm going to reduce this down to about 6 for now, see what that looks like. So we've got some nice dots there. Now we've got circles, and if we use the drop down dot properties, we can use this new feature which we've just released a video called pseudo Euclidean, which Nick has actually done a video explaining what that is, but it's a really cool effect that we've just added. But we're going to be using the symbol. Now if I just change that to square, you can see we've got square. If I change it to line, we've also got lines. We're going to go with symbol snow, because that's going to take our base symbol that we picked, and you can see here we've got our snow. I'm just going to click colorize so that we can give it the red of the original text. And we can also come up here and change this to say 30 degrees just to make it a little bit less uniform straight going across. Now that looks really cool. If you were doing something, creating a card or some wrapping paper, this is a really cool effect that Phantasm gives you that other plugins don't, even native doesn't give you. You only get the regular halftone pattern. So I already like this because it's in Phantasm, and it's such a big selling point if you do work with a brand that has an icon or icons or a logo. You can create some really cool effects with this because nobody else does it, and it will take you forever to do any other way. And it's also live, it's always constantly live. So what do we want to do? Well, let's just reduce that down to 4. Let's just make it a little bit bigger so we can see what's happening. So you can see there we've got holiday. I'm going to now say include variants. So I'm going to tick on that. And what it's done is it's gone and taken all of those variant symbols and put them in there as the Phantasm halftone pattern. Now I can have it randomly. I can ask it to do it consecutively, and that would give it some uniformity because it's taking it in the order that we created the variants. And that can be quite an interesting effect on its own. We can also do consecutively and in reverse order. But I quite like the randomness of it. I quite like that it's all different. Now again, if we want to, we can bump that back up to 8 and make them smaller. And they'll be really kind of fine icons. But what you have to remember, this is all still live vector. So we can zoom in a second once I've finished. We can also use the dot gain if we wanted to kind of make those a little bit less bulky, smaller, or we can fatten them up and make them more dense that way. But I'm going to pull it over here a little bit. I quite like that they're a little bit smaller there. So we're going to go ahead and click OK. So I'm happy with all of that. And if we wanted to, we can still change the color of the text. So maybe we want to go for a dark green. We can just change that to green. And it's still live text, so if we wanted to, we can change the word. But let's just zoom in and have a look at this, because I think this is a brilliant addition to Phantasm. If we zoom in there, you can see we've got these really cool little vectors. And if we wanted to, we can just take the whole thing and we can say object, expand appearance, and we just go object, expand one more time. And now what we've got is our word, but we've also, if we object ungroup, we've now got all these tiny little vectors that we've used to create a halftone pattern. Bit like we had in Stipulism. I think this is so cool. I'm so glad that our engineers were able to add this, because I'm just going to use this to death. But there you go. That's the brand new feature in Phantasm. It's really cool for if you want to do something for Christmas and impress your friends. But it really is as simple as just getting some symbols, creating a variant, and just using Phantasm to add it as the effect. So that's my two demos over. I hope you've enjoyed them. And don't forget to download your free packs. We've got some brushes from Von Glitchka. Then we've got the Christmas styles. Nick's brilliant pen and paper style pack, which is incredible. It really is complex. And we've got some videos on YouTube that show you how to use these. We've also got another vintage pack from Carlos. And we've obviously got our glitter brushes that I've already shown you. So go ahead and play with them, enjoy it. And I'm now going to hand this over to Nick. So thank you. So this is a little bonus add-on for those that joined the webinar yesterday. Obviously, we had to take some of the back half of the webinar down because it was new technology. that hasn't been released yet, and we don't want to just keep it on YouTube. So I'm just going to add a little bit of an extra feature to that last tutorial I did where I used the Phantasm symbol variants. So let's just click over here to the appearance panel and let's just click on the Phantasm halftone there. And I'm just going to change this DPI down to 6. I'm just going to make those icons a little bit bigger so you can see what we're doing. In fact, let's make it 8. Let's go for that. Then we can still see the word holiday. So I've got my grid angle of 30 degrees. I'm going to click OK. Then I'm going to come up here to Object, Expand Appearance. And that stops the text being live, and it also stops the Phantasm effect being live. You can see it's gone in the Appearance panel. Just going to click Expand once more. So now what I'm going to do is use a different one of our tools. And let's come over here, and we're going to use SuperMarquee. And what I want to do is actually change some of the colors of these icons. So rather than select the whole word, I'm just going to select letters at a time. And you can see from Astute Buddy, I've got some options here. So the A key lets me go through some alternating modes. So I'm just going to release that, and I'm going to change some of those to orange. Then I'm going to come over to the O, and I'm going to do the same again. And I'm going to hit the left and right arrow key just to make some changes there. Let's go for a red. We'll go through the L and I. Let's make some changes to that as well. There we go. I'm going to make that a different green. And you can see here, just by using Phantasm with this symbol variants and then expanding and using SuperMarquee, you can start to do some extra effects, extra changes really quickly than if you try to select these kind of individually or using the lasso tool up here, which you could kind of try and select some. But the cool thing about SuperMarquee tool is you can just make a selection. We can use R for the random mode, toggle random mode. I'm gonna go with that. Let's go for a blue, and let's just do those last couple, and we'll hit the A key again. Let's just change that there, and let's go for a purple. So there you go, really quickly we can just make some additional changes to that effect and go in, and if we just get the magnifying glass there, just zoom in, you can see now we've got all these different variations on color, and these are all still individual little items. So if we ungroup that, we could even go into find replace, and then maybe say you didn't want the gingerbread men in there, you wanted to change it for something else. Using find and replace, you could actually go into the artwork and say find all the symbols of this size, of this geometry, of any size, and replace it with something else. So there's always a tool to help you go a step further, but I just thought I'd add this little bit extra in because it's still quite fun to keep building on some of the effects that you can use with Astute Graphics. So thanks for watching. Thanks for sticking us with us in 2020. We look forward to doing more webinars and tutorials for you in 2021. And it'll all be here on YouTube/AstuteGraphics/live and just our regular channel as well. So have a great Christmas and Happy New Year, and we'll see you next time.